So thank you very much for coming here. This is for Pickleball Coaching International. And my name is Larry Gordon. This is David, Kathy, Tammy. You're going to be my students today. So to introduce you to what we're going to do, we're going to have an agenda throughout the next hour. And I'm going to go ahead and move you around the courts in different areas. And we're going to play a couple different times during the hour. We're going to serve, return, serve. We're going to dink. And we're going to learn how we got from here to there, from the backcourt to the forecourt. And if you have any questions, you know, if it's relevant while we're doing it, please ask them, okay? And at the very end, though, we're going to have a question and answer session, so you can be able to ask anything. Okay? Ready? So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to dink. So come on up here, one person, two people here, and I'm going to come on the other side. 0-0. Always call the score first. On two.
Exciting, right?
Yeah.
We get a lot of ball sacks.
Yeah. we're going to work on Dinky. So, think a couple with each other. I got to get my cones, all right? Thank you.
now we're going to go ahead and see how we got here. So we're going to get here by thinking. So now I want our side is going to try and keep you back. I want you both to take three large steps back. Like with Kathy.
Thank you.
Dave, you're good.
I'm a float.
So we're doing fine. Everybody, I think, is getting the feeling for this. We're taking a water break now. It's about 90 degrees here in South Florida, so we must hydrate. Be back with you. We'll keep the camera rolling.
Great.
We're going to serve and we're going to return serve. Okay? Any two can stay here and any two can go over there, so whenever you decide. Right? And thank you. Yeah. So, we're going to serve first. What your job is to do is to, we're going to be working on serving and returning the first time to be returned. What I'd like from you all to do is to hit your returns, pass these lines, or to the center.
Not by swinging that much harder. The elbow in, and I want to see you really finish.
good. That's really good. You really finish. Accelerating it. That's very good. So aim, I want you to aim left. Serve to somebody and have more success, learn to serve to their backhands. Because to their backhands is where you're going to end up being able to do the most damage, unless they happen to have a backhand better than their forehand, which you can determine as a thinking person. So, you know, practice, when you come out to play and you practice your dinking and you practice all the shots, practice serves. Come out and take three or four practice serves before you start your game. Everybody's allowed. And aim at the player's backhands a little once in a while. And you'll see that you'll get some success. Because the receiver does have the advantage. Some points now, and we're going to use what we learn. We're going to serve, we're going to return serve, we're going to dink, we're going to volley, and we're going to learn to approach with the long dink and see how they do. That was practice.
running through the ball and you stop, the ball, you can control where the ball pads are going to be. But if you're running while you're hitting, you think you're going to hit it there, and all of a sudden the ball is somewhere else. Right?
Take your time, man. So remember, you're going to feed it out of your hand. Successes with parents. Alright? You know, you learn arithmetic by making mistakes before you got this right answer. 0-2-2.
Contact.
You see the ball on your path.
Like,
serve either.
So, what I want to say is, first of all, is thank you very much. Like, this has been great.
You're welcome.
Everybody made progress during the hour. Do you have a question? Anything about anything that we talked about?
Just trying to think. Deep serve, deep return.
Well, let me review. We talked about deep serves. Yeah. We talked about returning deep. There's something about depth that's more important than speed. Because depth is a small court, and you want to keep your opponents back on their heels as much as you can. And depth does that much better than any other mechanism. Okay. Any questions?
The middle one, who's supposed to get it?
So the middle one is a really interesting thing. So it's like we have an X. So if the ball's coming from this direction, and it's here, but you're both... It belongs to this player. Right, it goes along the X. And if the ball's coming from this direction, you go this way. The exception would be if the player is going to poach.
Yeah,
and we're going to poach to have an offensive situation, not to poach and be defensive. You poach for offense. Okay? So you would poach along the... If the ball's coming on the X, ball's over here and you have the forehand and you think that you see a big opening, the person didn't make it back to, towards the middle or anything.
How do you, what do you feel about poaching?
I feel, the question is, what do I feel about poaching? I think poaching is a great thing to do when the players understand each other. When the players don't understand each other, then it just puts people out of position. But if you're going to poach, we're doing it for offense because each side of the court has a different vision or view of the play because you're in a different location. So sometimes the poacher might see an avenue of opportunity that the other side could never see. And then it's a good thing, okay? But if you're just going to go there because you think you're a better player and you just want to get the ball back, we'll let your partner play.
Or you don't want
I mean, there's only 10 feet of court on each side. Let your partner play a lot. You know,
some people do it because they have a weak partner too.
If you're playing, the question, the comment is that sometimes the partner's much weaker, and that's true. But you know, these are rec games. So, you know, the only way your partner's going to get better is if they get shots hitting the ball, which comes to the final thing. We started the day with some practice. I encourage everybody to practice. I encourage you when you come out to play, not just to play and hit three balls and say, okay, I'll warm up in the first game. Take 5 or 10 minutes, 10 minutes, and warm up. I come out a half hour minimum before play and I warm up, okay? And you're going to find that your game is going to improve that way. I thank you all very much. Namaste. Thank you. And thank you to Benjamin, the videographer.
Thanks, Benjamin.
You going to edit it?
Don't keep coming. No way.